Hey guys, I'm back. So today I'm going to go over to the Raging Chasm, because I'm going to see if I can solo it. I'm level 20 now. So it looks like I cannot go anywhere near the Undercity right now. I don't have enough money, I just bought the mount. So I guess I will go do this quest, the Traitor's Destruction, and get this guy's head. So, let's make our way over there. I got this beautiful chicken. Blue. One of my favorite colors. So let's make our way. Over there. And then I will, of course, try to do the Raging Chasm alone next time. Hey guys, so I'm back. I just put myself in the Dungeon Finder. I'm going to go for the Deadmines. I'm going to see if I can do that in a group. I'm level 20 right now, so since my last episode, I have increased my level by a lot. This is because questing in this game, each quest is really either go find some object somewhere or kill 20 guys and then, you know, bring back their items. So it's very repetitive. That's one of the reasons why I don't really play this game frequently. I play in spurts about a month at a time, and then stop. Then I come back and try a different character. Because it is, I wouldn't say addicting, but it is fun. You know, it is cool to be in this world. I like being in a world with a lot of different people. That's why this game, I decided to do a PvP for the first time, to see what this game actually has to offer. Every other time I've done player versus environment. So in that mode, you don't really have to fear fighting other players. But now in this mode, if I actually go into the Lion's territory, I might just get wrecked, because I know there's characters with a whole bunch of equipment. People are level 110 now. And I'm just starting out. Eventually, I haven't bought Legion yet, but I might buy Legion eventually. And then play Legion. So I might use the level 100 character boost on this character. Don't know for sure yet. We'll see how these videos turn out. This big guy, when I first started fighting him a few levels ago, it was so hard, but now it's pretty easy, which is one thing I like about this game. You really feel a sense of progression when you're in these lower zones. Now, while I'm waiting for this to get into this dungeon, I will go and see if I can do this quest. A Traitor's Destruction, where I need to get this guy's head. I think I've done about 5 of these kind of quests where I have to go kill some kind of mini-boss, get their head, and then bring it all the way back to the quest giver. These quests are okay, but I kind of prefer dungeons because you can jump into a dungeon at any time and then beat it. And then you have like 5 different huge bosses, and they're just a lot of fun. Let's see. Oh, I'm poisoned. That's awesome. So I'm trying to find some dude in here who... Oh, there he is. You can see him on the map. At this point, these bad guys are not really that strong anymore. Hit level 20, so... Okay, so he's up here. So now we can start destroying everybody. Now, if you don't have heirloom gear, you should really get some if you're going to start new characters, because heirloom gear is just so helpful when starting a new character. It's almost like a new game plus. Like, if you remember those old JRPGs where you would get all the best items, start a new game, and then you could actually play for collectibles. So I guess this guy is down here.
I need to talk.
Right. One thing I need to do is get bag space. Because I haven't really bought any good bags yet, and my bags do fill up quickly. Oh, this is a guy. So, rats. Oh, this guy's tough. Wow, okay. I just got wrecked. So I guess I'll have to walk all the way back. Nope. How far is it? I hope it's not that far. Not really sure I am. So, anyway, I will fast forward through this and then get back to where I was. So, I'll be right back. Alright, so I'm back where I was before. I'll try to do this smarter this time. Fortunately, I don't think I have any health potions, so I'm going to wait a little while for my health to recharge and go back down there. Should have been able to just wreck those guys, but I need to work on my kiting skill to be able to run away from enemies. And I need to know what the limitations of the hunter are, because in the open world, it's great. I can run.
I can't attack that. I need to target something first.
I can run around and get where I need to go, quickly defeat enemies out in the open field, but when you're enclosed like this, it's kind of difficult. Alright, so it's just him, and should be good on health. So let's get my dire beast in there, attack with my little guy, and then just try to wreck him. I'm doing much better this time. I guess when I'm being mobbed by a group of five people, it's way more difficult because I'm trying to hit multiple targets at the same time. Now, I did get this ability called multi-shot. Oh, got him. Multi-shot, you can hit more than one person at the same time. But in a closed environment like this, I don't know how effective it is. Oh. Killed my spider. Let's revive him. Okay. Now, I tamed a spider as a pet because he has this web ability that slows the movement speed of them, which helps me either run away or helps me kite them a little bit better. Oh. Which is good for a hunter. Because on the hunter, I'm always supposed to be on the move. I'm supposed to strike from far. When an enemy gets too close, I've done something wrong. Like I just saw when I died. So I'm gonna fast forward through this bit a little. And get back where I'm supposed to give this head. Just let me look on the map. Where's that supposed to? Okay, I need to walk all the way back there. So I will be right back. Alright, so just got back to the quest giver, giving him stuff, the head that I got, and now I'm trying to decide my reward. Now I don't need any of this gear, so I'm just going to pick the one that can sell for the most, which is the staff. So I'm going to complete this quest. Alright, so they want me to go back to some rooms. Alright, I'll probably complete that quest and end this episode because it looks like this dungeon finder... Oh, never mind. They're just waiting for a tank. It's good, so I might be able to get in on that. In the meantime, I'm going to see if I can get to Zolomon. So this way. Just activate that flight spot. Because once I activate that, then I'll have another place I can quickly travel to. Having flights, don't know what they're called, but the flight spots open really helps when you're trying to get around quickly. Especially if you don't have a mage. With a mage character, you can teleport to pretty much any city you want in the game and quickly traverse the world. If you don't have a mage, then there's certain items that can do it. Like, I really want to get a guild cloak. I've read that they can teleport you to your home city, and then I can set my Hearthstone somewhere else. That'd be nice, but I haven't really seen them around. I think I actually need to join a guild to be able to do that. So, if anybody who is part of a good guild, you know, feel free to send me a request to join. All right, here we go. We got the little flight guy. Oh, am I in Alliance territory?
Yo!
I don't think so.
What's up?
Okay, so... gonna fast forward through this. Oh, sweet. Deadmines. Finally get in. Took a while. Wonder what happens if I'm on a flying thing while I get in. I don't know. So I guess I won't fast forward. I'll just wait for this to come up. So dungeons are really cool because you can go in and you kind of share the loot. Oh, okay. Never mind. Oh, let's try this again. I hate that when people decline an invite. Like, why even set up for a queue if you're going to decline? Doesn't make any sense. Come on, tank. Just click accept. There we go. Alright, so I'm in the Deadmines, so this should be pretty quick. This is the easiest of the dungeons. Stacked all of these. This should actually level me up. Which, that'll be good. So, these quests are basically defeat the bosses. Which will be easy enough. I wait a minute. I need my pet. Where's my pet? There it is. I need that. Oh. I probably won't need a lot of these items I'll be getting, so I'm just gonna put greed on most of them unless it's a bow. Like, because really all I do is sell them. Because right now I'm in most need of money. Money would be useful, and I'll be able to get to the Rage Sarcasm and then solo it in the next episode. Now, considering how I can't really one-hit kill all these monsters in this dungeon, I don't know if I'll be able to solo that dungeon now. So maybe I'll do some leveling up before I get there. Maybe try to get to level 25 or 30. Like to level 30, so then I can add another talent. The talent that I chose for now is a talent that makes my Cobra Shot, which is my main attack down here. Increases its power by 10%. Which is really helpful. But I've heard that right now I'm a Beastmaster. I've heard that gold flint gloves, so I'll take them. My gloves price up. I've heard that being a marksman is actually better. So I might experiment with being a marksman, but I kind of like having a pet as a mini tank. One that will absorb and distract enemies so I can shoot them from afar. All these guys are getting my way. Oh, good. Got it. If it binds to you, then you can sell them on auction. And you can usually get more money for things if you sell them on auction house. So, that's what most people do. Instead of finding dungeons. So if I'm in quick need for cash, I'll just sell it. But really, it's stuff that you can get through is not really worth that much. Pants. Oh, this shit's awesome. Yeah, I'll take that. I need to target something. Oh, my pet's dead. So I'll revive him. Sweet. usually like playing like tank dungeons, but I'll have to just learn how to play as a hunter. Just do damage from far. That's all I'm supposed to do. Oh, this is... One robot town.
I need to target something first.
These enemies are really cool. You can actually become one of them for one quest if you're alliance. Alright. So I think we're waiting for Foe Reaper 5000? Yep, let's go. So, Dire Beast, Hello Shot. Got my Beast of Damage. Just keep on attacking. Oh, confusing. Dire Beast. Run through the different types I have. Okay, he's dead. I don't need that. Greet it. Okay, dungeon's really cool because you can just get in, play a dungeon in like 10, 15 minutes, and then stop playing for the day. It's a really good way to consistently get good items while not investing a whole bunch of time. But to really level up, but you can invest some time. Which is unfortunate. This is definitely not a game like Call of Duty. I guess it is a role playing game, usually they have a bunch of time to play. This. Read it. That's pretty cool. We're in the last leg of the dungeon now. There's currently a pirate ship indoors for some reason. This is it. Indoor pirate ship. So. Kill these birds. I think they've got bombs on them. No, the ship is shooting bombs. You get hit by the bomb, then it brings you off this bridge, and you just pretty much start in the beginning. It's annoying, it doesn't take any time to get back, but...
I need to talk.
I've played this dungeon so many times on other characters. It's a quick dungeon. There's some good stuff in the game. If you're a ranged character, you really need to use the tab button if there's... I'll greet it. Something I can tell. If anybody wants to subscribe for it, it'll be on the option. Now, I picked this server because I had a medium population. So... not really clear to me if medium population means that there's more players, or if all the players are just such a high level that not a lot of new people are starting. Because in the home city of Silvermoon, there's pretty much no one in the auction house. While in Stormwind, the Alliance capital city, there's a ton of people. Maybe I need to go to the Undercity, since that is the Horde capital city, I think. Then maybe they'll have more people in the auction house. It's just weird seeing an empty auction house and not used to it at all. we're almost done with this. I'll go back to Silvermoon. Complete the quests I was doing. And then, I'll be done this episode. I'm really glad that I was able to do this Deadmines. It's kind of hard to find. What? Okay. Forgot about this. Let's fog up then. Pulls out nowhere. Okay, can one hit these guys.
I need to target something.
Really? It's almost dead. Good. We done. I kind of want this. Really won that game. I didn't get it. Well, I know that I had intelligence stat, not intelligence, but kind of wanted. Read that.
Go, go! Careful out there.
Where's this person?
Go with God.
Where's Captain Cookie? Really? Oh. Okay, I guess I'll abandon this since apparently I already killed him. Alright, now how do I leave the instance? I don't remember. Anybody knows an easier way to leave the instance, that'd be great. Oh, there we go. Oh, just starts me back on the flying thing. A different flying thing. Alright, so I take this guy's head to Lord Thamar. Theron. Like Charlie's there. Cool. And then I will end the episode if he eventually gets there. This dead scar is kind of cool. I guess it just broke through the city and destroyed everything. I was watching another video where he explained why the city is wrecked. It's interesting. Let's go. Oh, sweet. That's one thing. When you do a dungeon, you do get more money than just walking around. Usually. I'm sure later, when I get to more difficult zones, I'll get more money from enemies. But in these starting zones, you get absolutely nothing. Alright, so, okay, I need to go all the way to the Sun Fury Spire. Cool. I want to hit level 20 and get a mount. Getting around is so much easier. It's kind of frustrating when you're walking because you're walking so slow. This world is big by comparison. But just having the slow mount will make it a lot less dreadful. Alright, so we're going up. Ooh. This capital city is pretty good looking. Lots of oranges though. Kind of wish it was a better color palette. Alright.
As Regent Lord of the Wealth of Dark Hound's Head, I will defend my people against any who do us harm.
Alright, now my next quest would be to go to the Honor City. So I will go to Honor City, probably off camera, and then and get everything set up to try to solo the Ragefire Chasm. And that will be my next episode. So anyway. Bye guys. Bye.